Good morning, student. Today we will discuss our fifth unit, Children and Women in Sports. Growth and development is important part of life. Growth means increase in size, weight, height, etc. And it can be measures, means growth is a quantitative change which can be measured. Development is a qualitative change or change in quality or its function. Development implies overall change in shape, form, structures, result in proper functioning in it. It is a change in quality or characters rather than change in quantitative aspect. Okay, growth and development. It is a very important part of life. Growth means increase in size, weight, height, etc. Like increase in weight, increase in height, etc. And growth, it can be measured. Development is a qualitative change. Means change in quality or characters which have been proper functioning. And development, it can't be measured. In children's physical activity play an important role for optimum growth and development. If a child participates in physical activity, it's helps in optimum growth and development of his body. Motor development activities helps to attain full growth and development. So motor development in children's. Motor development is related to smooth and coordinate movement. If there is proper motor development, then there will be the smooth and coordinate movement. Motor development refers to the development of child bones, muscles, and ability to move around and manipulate in their environment. If the child bones is developed, muscle is developed, then he will easily control his movement, easily react and control his movement and manipulate in their environment. So in motor development, proper development of child bones, muscles and abilities should be required. Thus motor developments, if there is a motor development, then the child learn to sit, stand, walk, etc. Thus it is the study of change in motor development. In fact, motor development is a combination of physical fitness along with large muscle. Physical fitness, that is strength, speed, flexibility, endurance. It is a physical fitness. Motor development, it is a combination of physical fitness with along with large muscle, small muscles, bones and nervous systems. Motor development provides perfection in actions and graceful movement. If there is a motor development, then our movement will be perfect. Motor development in child is divided into two parts: gross motor development and fine motor development. Gross motor development means development of big or large muscle, like muscle of the hand, leg, etc. The development of big muscles help the child to do big activity like running, walking, jumping, standing, sitting, etc. Next is fine motor development. Fine motor development means development of small muscle like muscle of the hand, finger, etc. This development of small muscles helps them to do a fine work, small work like drawing, catching, painting, skill perfection, writing, etc. With the help of fine motor development, with the help of small muscle development. So motor development means development of child bones, muscle and ability to move around and manipulate in the environment. If there is a proper growth and development of bones and muscles, then the movement of the child will be perfect. There are two types of motor development, gross motor development and fine motor development. Gross motor development means development of big muscles which help the child to do big activity like running, walking, jumping, and fine motor development. Fine motor development means development of small muscle. Small muscles, if the small muscle develop like the development of finger muscle, etc. This small muscle developments help the child to do small activity like drawing, doing the skill perfection work, balancing, catching, throwing, etc. Next is factors affecting motor development. What are the factors that affect motor development? First is parents and heredity. Child get genes from parents as heredity. Thus, the motor development follow the same patterns as their parents. Nutrition. Nutrition foods provide proper motor development, good motor development. If a child take a proper nutritional foods, then that will be the proper motor development. But if there is if the child does not take a proper diet, then it affect his motor development. There will be the no motor development. So for proper motor development, good diet should be taken. Immunizations. If mothers and child both are immunized at proper time, means both are vaccination of child and mothers at a better time, at a proper time, it leads to good motor development. If immunizations helps to protect the child from disease, infections, etc. So for proper motor development, proper immunization at a proper time should be taken. Environment. If the child live in clean, safe and natural environment, healthy environment, then there will be the good motor development. Psychological feedback and motivation. The children should be encouraged and motivated to perform physical activity, because if the child participate in physical activity, then his motor development will be good. Therefore, we should motivate them. We should provide them feedback, psychological feedback, so that they participate in the physical activity, which help in motor development. Disability and disease. Disability and disease affect the motor development. It reduces perfections in motor skill. If the person is disabled, if it is disease, then his perfections in motor skill will be reduced. Whereas if the person is healthy, fit, then there will be the faster motor development. Regular practice. With regular practice, motor development is improved and perfection is gained. Body weight, overweight and overweight children have less motor development. Whereas if the child is healthy, then his motor development will be good. He has more skill. His skill in perfection, his skill will be perfect if the child is healthy. Mental ability. Motor development is also depend upon mental level. Thus, small children have less perfection in his movement, and in mature, in adult, their movement will be perfect. Gender or sex difference. There is a difference of motor development between boys and girls. Rest and relaxation. Proper rest. If the child take proper rest, proper relax, then there will be the proper motor development. Otherwise, motor development will be delayed or affected. Proper training. For motor development and skill perfection, proper coaching and training is required. Safety measure. Safety measures should be considered to gain perfection in motor skill. Interest and attitude. The interest and attitude of the child is one of the important factors for motor development. Therefore, the child should have interest in physical activity. His attitude should be good. Multi-activity. The child should participate in multi-activity. If he participate in multi-activity, it's help to develop good skill, good motor skill. These are the factors that affect motor development. Parents and heredity, nutrition, immunizations, environment. Parents and heredity, this motor development follow the same patterns as their parents. Nutrition, for proper motor development, he should take proper nutritional diet. Immunizations, he should be properly immunized at the proper time so as to protect it from the disease infection. He should live in clean, healthy, natural environment. Psychology feedback, we should provide in psychological feedback, motivation, so that he will participate in physical activity. Disease, disability and disease. If the person is disability, then his motor development is delayed. Regular practice, for proper motor development, regular practice is required. Body weight, if the person is overweight, then there is less motor development as compared to fit and healthy person. Mental ability, usually the small children has less perfection in his motor development, in his movement. Rest and relaxation is also required for proper motor development. He should do a proper training. Safety measures, he should have interest, he should participate in multi-activity, etc. Next is exercise guidelines at different stages of motor, stages of growth and development. What exercise we should do at different stages of growth and development. There are different stages of growth and development, like babyhood stage, that is from birth to 1 year, infancy, that is from 1 to 2 years, early childhood, that is from 2 to 6 years, later childhood, that is from 7 to 12 years, adolescence, 13 to 19 years, adulthood more than 19 years, and oldest person more than 60. These are the stages of growth and development. And in this stage, what exercise we should do? So let's discuss. First stage is babyhood growth and development, that is from birth to 1 year. The motor development start after birth and follow the progressive and sequential patterns from top to bottom. As the child get birth, the motor development start. The baby first learn to move, but his control is missing. That is, the gross motor development take place. In babyhood, the gross motor development take place, that is development of his big muscles, because at this stage the child is unable to control himself. His controlling power is missing. It happened primarily at neck, shoulders, arm, hands, leg, etc. Fine motor development is missing, like is unable to control over his finger, face, muscle, etc. And at this stage, what exercise, what activity the babyhood should do? At this stage, gross motor development is taken. Therefore, the child should do the activity like crawling, sitting, standing, walking, etc. And at this stage, the parents should take a proper care. She should provide healthy diet, clean and safe environment, proper vaccination of a child, immunization should be done so that proper motor development should take place. Infancy growth and development, that is from 1 to 2 years. At this stage, is also known as toddler stage. At this stage, gross motor development is concerned. Parents should provide healthy diet, playful environment for gross motor development. At this stage also, the gross motor development take place. Therefore, he should provide healthy environment, playful ground. They should check the proper growth and development of the child, and they should consult the doctors for the same. What activity at this stage the child should do? The activity like crawling, standing, sitting, walking, rolling, bending, stepping, blocking, building, etc. These are the activities which the child do. The infants should take sufficient rest. It should take proper rest, sleep, along with proper vaccination. And at this time also, the parents should provide him safe, clean and hygienic environment. Next is early childhood growth and development. Early childhood growth and development, that is from 2 to 6 years. At this stage, the main concern is development of gross motor component along with fine motor component. Okay, in this stage, gross motor development and fine motor development take place. The child should be provided healthy and playful activity. Special care should be given. Special diet, environment, habits, moral value, recreational activities should be provided for proper gross and fine motor development. At this stage, what activities the child should do? The gross motor development activity like running, throwing, kicking, catching, tricycles, ride, ladders, climbing, hooping, etc. These are the activity the child should participate for proper gross motor development, that is for development of big muscle. Later childhood growth and development. Later childhood growth and development, that is from 7 to 12 years of child. In this stage also, gross and fine motor development activities is performed. Okay, in this stage gross and fine motor development take place. So for gross and fine motor development, the activities, this type of activities should be do like yoga, gymnastics, athletics, swimming, team game like football, basketball, handball, volleyball, racket games, badminton, etc. This type of activity the child should perform at this stage for proper gross and fine motor development. Next is adolescence growth and development, that is from 13 to 19 years. Adolescence 13 to 19 years. This period is delicate period and challenging period for parents. The sex difference is prominent and brings us consciousness in this stage. Adolescence is caused many changes related to physical, social and psychological. So, okay, this stage, it is a very dangerous stage for the parents due to the lack of knowledge, lack of experience. They have the knowledge but they have less experience. Therefore, it is a delicate period. At this stage also, the various changes take place. Physical change, social change, psychological change. Therefore, the parents should take a proper care of the child. Activities at this stage, you should have a proper diet, do a heavy activity. The child has full energy, maximum energy. Therefore, he should perform a heavy physical workout, creative activity. He should participate in team game. Teenagers should motivate to develop moral value, controlling his emotion, proper use of finance, etc. These are the activities for adolescents. So, the exercise guideline at different stages of growth and development, what types of activities, what type of exercise we should do at the different stages of growth and development, that is babyhood. In babyhood, growth and development, gross motor development take place. Therefore, the child should participate, the child should do the activities like crawling, rolling, walking, standing, sitting, gross motor development, and there is no fine motor development. Therefore, the child is unable to control himself. Infancy also, the gross motor development take place. Therefore, the child should be provided healthy diet, safe and healthy environment. He should perform in the activities like standing, sitting, rolling, crawling, walking, etc. At early childhood stage, gross motor development and fine motor development take place, and he should also provide healthy, balanced diet, nutritional food, healthy environment, playful activities, etc. And he should perform the activities like hooping, climbing, throwing, running, kicking, etc. And later childhood also, gross motor development and fine motor development take place. Okay, both gross motor development, that is development of big muscle, and development of small muscle take place. Therefore, the child should participate in the activity like yoga, gymnastics, swimming, volleyball, handball, football, etc. And the last stage is adolescence, that is from 13 to 19 years. In this stage also, there is a gross and fine motor development. At this stage, the child has more energy. Therefore, he should participate in heavy physical workout. This is a delicate period. The child has knowledge, but they have lack of experience. They have lack of practical knowledge. Therefore, the parents should take a proper care in adolescence stage. Many changes take place, like physical change, social change, psychological change. Therefore, the child should be provided proper knowledge, proper guidance. Activities, the child should provide good diet. He should participate in heavy physical workout, team game activity. And also, we should teach them to control their emotion for proper use of finance, etc. Next is posture. Posture, it is a specific body position. That is position of body. Posture means position of body. Posture, it may be static and dynamic. Static like standing, sitting, and dynamic like walking, running, etc. Posture means balancing the body. Okay, posture means specific position of body, and it may be static and dynamic. Balancing the body in accurate and proper manners so as to provide least fatigue. If you have good postures, then you will have least fatigue. So we should have proper and accurate posture so that it leads to least fatigue. Posture, there are different view about posture. According to physical educationist Postures is on tools of mechanical efficiency of body, which causes minimum stress to muscle. Moreover, maximum output of physical efficiency. For doctors, posture means soundness or physiological balance of body. If the physiological balance of body is sound, good, then the person has good posture. And for actors, posture means to express his emotion, express his attitude. If the person is able to express his emotion, attitude in a good manner, it means he has a good posture. So, from this, we conclude that good postures help the body to function efficiently and effectively. If the person has good postures, it helps the body to function properly and efficiently. Good postures also improve the personality of an individual. His personality will be attractive. It shows expression, emotion, attitude, guidance. The efficiency of the body also depend upon good posture. If the posture is good, his efficiency will be also good. It directs the health status. Posture also show the health status of a child, of a person. If a person posture is good, it means he is fit, healthy. And postures, if we have postures, good postures, if we have good postures, it keeps our bones in their natural shape and in a proper alignment, helps to keep our sound body, etc. So posture means positions or pose. The best posture is that when there is a least fatigue. And posture, there are different view regarding the posture. For physical educationists, posture means different. For doctor, posture means different. And for actors, the meaning of posture is different. So from this, we can conclude that posture means good. If the person has good postures, then his body will function efficiently and effectively. His personality will also improve. It's help to its postures have to express his emotion, attitude of mind, etc. Posture have to express process, so the expression of the emotion, attitude, etc. The good postures also depend upon the efficiency of body depend upon good posture. It is directly related to the health. If a person had good postures, he has a good health. And if a person has a good postures, it keep our body sound, keep our bones healthy, fit, and in a natural shape. And also the persons will not get easily tired. He will not feel fatigue while doing any activity if a person has good posture. For correct standing posture, in correct standing postures, your head should be straight. The correct standing postures is held without any sense of effort. Standing, it is a position in which the body is held upright positions with supported. Your feet should be apart, slightly open your feet about 4 to 6 inches. That is shoulder distance. Open your leg at a shoulder distance. Your feet should be parallel to the ground, and your body weight should be balanced on both the leg. It should be balanced on both the feet, and you should look the straight. Your backbone should be straight, erect, etc. This is the correct standing position. This head, shoulders and neck, it should be in a straight line. So we have discussed about postures. Means postures means the positions. It is a position of your body. It is a specific position of the body, and the posture may be static or dynamic. Static means fixed, like standing in a fixed point, sitting in a fixed point, and dynamic. Dynamics means motions like running, jumping, etc.